our jazz ensemble. And the first tune we will open up with is called Hallelujah Time. It's from the Woody Herman Band, mid-1960s. A few generations, a few decades they did this tune. My favorite, the version we're doing, is from the 60s. 63, 64, and this will feature Zach on alto and Dean Forbes on tenor saxophone. That's the drummer, Eric Landau. Here we are with Hallelujah Time. Stan Kenton is a feature player. started his own band, which is some of my favorite BPM music. And this is called A Country Boy. And this will feature Gideon Dan on tenor and Eric Quinn as our country boy on trombone.
Thank you.
special guests that will join us. This next tune, we will be joined by Bill Street. This is a classic, beautiful bossa nova, and it's called Pensativa. It's been recorded by many, many, many jazz musicians over the last probably 3 decades, or a little bit more. And this is an arrangement of Durrett's, correct? Right. So this is, Claire wrote the tune, Pensativa, and his brother Durrett, who is a trumpeter and arranger, arranged it for Big Band. And Claire had recorded it, and it had been typically a small group tune. And this is, I think, maybe the first Big Band arrangement. So here we go. This will feature Bill and the band, Pensativa.
Thank you.
You're still on this one. Well, Robbie? Nice to be the same man, Robbie. You're coming to work. You want to tell him something about us?
Well, I knew Claire personally. I worked with him. We were at school together at Michigan State University. And he was the most unusual talent I think I've ever run into, a true genius in every respect. I used to catch him when I would come back from a gig like at 2:30 in the morning. He'd be off in some practice room blowing his brains out on the piano, and he'd be still there in the morning at 6 in when we get out of bed. It's amazing, just an amazing player. But he's written so many charts over the years. From all kinds of different bands. He got his big break writing for Dizzy Gillespie. Dizzy Gillespie plays Ellington, I think is the name of the album. And Claire was commissioned to write all the arrangements. And that just sent him off into great, great acclaim and so forth. And he was just, took off from there. He had a big band for years out in California. And that's where a lot of these charts came from. His brother also wrote for the big band at Claire had. And this next tune that we're going to play is called Gorabi. It's actually taken from the name of a town in Venezuela, where he used to like to hang out because he was very fond of Latin rhythms, and he was compulsive about it. He wanted always to be authentic. And his rhythms and the way he wrote the rhythms and so forth. So he'd hang out down in South American countries and cities and so forth and listen and transcribe and then put them all together. So this was originally written for Cal Jader Quintet, and they played it for a number of years, and he kept hearing an expanded version of it, and finally he wrote it down for huge big band, and that's what we're going to do now.
This will feature also Mike Healy on piano, and Bill, of course, at the end, Gideon Forbes again on alto this time, Mark Chalemi on trumpet,
woo!
And our percussion section, Matt Johnston and Eric Handa.
Thank you.
writing a couple of years ago.
Well, I'll tell you what I know about it. It was written by Dirk, Clare's brother. It's one of the earliest arrangements that Dirk wrote for Clare's band. Escalera is a Spanish word for stairway or escalator. I should take the stairs over the escalator, I know. And well, I just want to thank you all for coming, and we hope you enjoy this. This is true, right? Definitely take the stairs. This elevator has a sign that says, "For your hell, take the stairs."
You deviated off the grid a little bit.
Yeah.
was, in addition to all that Latin influence that Claire Fisher had, he also wrote a lot for pop artists and acts you know, such as Paul McCartney, Michael Jackson, Prince, Rufus, and Chaka Khan, which is the chart we're going to play. So this next chart is called Rags to Rufus, which was one of the Rufus featured Chaka Khan albums in the 70s, like mid to late 70s. This is called Rags to Rufus. This will feature Elias Cottle on guitar and Dee Dee Williams again on tenor sax.
Woo!
much for coming out, supporting live jazz here in the U.S. Now, coming to hear the combo, the Barry Saunders combo. And the jazz ensemble. It's been a real treat to perform this music. It's rare. It's the first time I've ever seen any of the composition stuff, other than this next one we're going to play, which I saw a few years ago when Bill brought it, and he had all the stuff in his basement. I need to find out what more he has in that. That's another gun. So, but anyway, thank you very much. Thank you to Bill for sharing your music with Claire Fisher with us. It's been a treat and a lot of work, and with any minute of it, to work on this stuff. It's rare. Likely, most of us will never get to play again. But then you like to go. It's that rare. So, without further ado, we're going to finish with the Duke. I'd like to bring Bill. Bill! No, I'm not hard of hearing. Bill and Barry back up to join us. We're going to play the Duke, which is a tribute to Duke Ellington or John Wayne. This will feature a couple of people you haven't heard from yet. Carl Firm on baritone saxophone. And Nick Centeno on tenor saxophone. Bill, Barry, and Mike Beeling again on piano. For coming out and listening to the jazz ensemble. Enjoy the good concert. Thank you.
Thank you.